بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، الحمد للہ وکفا وسلام علی عبادہ الذین اصطفیٰ، اما بعد، قال اللہ تبارک و تعالی فی الکلام المجید والفرقان الحمید، بعد اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم، بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، یا ایہا الذین آمنوا توبوا الی اللہ توبۃ نصوحا، قال رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم، بلغوا عنی ولو آیا، صدق اللہ مولانا العظیم و صدق رسول النبی الکریم، و نحن ولا ذالک من الشاہدین و الشاکرین، والحمد للہ رب العالمین، ان اللہ و ملائکتہ یصلون علی النبی، یا ایہا الذین آمنوا صلوا علیہ وسلم تسلیما، اللہم صلی علی سیدنا محمد و علی آل سیدنا محمد و بارک وسلم وسلی علیہ، رب اشرح لی صدری و یسر لی امری و احلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہ قولی، رب زدنی علما، سبحانک لا علم لنا الا ما علمتنا انک انت العلیم الحکیم۔ مائی موسٹ رسپیکٹ برادرز اینڈ سسٹرز، ناظرین ان اسلام، السلام علیکم رحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ۔ الحمدللہ، فسٹ آف آل آئی کانگریچولیٹ the whole Muslim Ummah for Eid al-Adha, and especially all those hujjaj who went to Hajj, performed the rites of the Hajj. We should make dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them with Hajj Mabroor. Ameen. As well as may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with their du'as, what they made in the Haram Main Sharif. We know that what is the purpose of the Hajj. Of course, this is the fifth pillar of Islam. It is the first who can afford. But the ruh of the Hajj, the spirit of the Hajj, what is that? That is that every Haji has to be present in Arafat. What the main objective and goal in the Arafat, there's a tawbah, repentance, to seek forgiveness from every kind of sins if they committed. So we also over here on the Arafat day, 9th of Zilhijjah, we do fasting. And we enjoy the reward. 1 year past, 1 year future, our sins have been forgiven. We have this belief. So I quoted before you the Ayat-e Mubarakah, Surah At-Tahrim, Ayat number 8. The simple meaning of the Ayat-e Mubarakah, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, O believers, men, women, adult, akil, baligh, ya ayyuhallazina amanu, who have committed, Allah is only our Rabb. And Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is our last prophet. Of course, we believe all other prophets also, other ingredient of iman. So khitab is to the mu'minin, to me and you. And unto the day of Qiyamah, Ya ayyuhallazin amanu, tubu ilallah. He taubatan nasuha. Tubu ilallah he taubatan nasuha. Do tauba. Do repentance from every kind of sin. And this tauba should be sincere tauba, a true tauba. This tauba should not be a lip service. Of course, we declare tauba from the tongue, from the heart, as well as we do body action to prove I'm doing sachi tauba. What is tauba? That to promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what sin I committed, I will not do no more. Stopping from right this moment and never repeat it. There are certain conditions of the tawbah. First of all, we should accept our jurm, our crime, our sin, maybe it's small, maybe it's big. And then we promise with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will not do it again. As well as we should stop that particular sin right away. And give musammam irada, firm commitment, that Ya Allah, I will not do again. For that purpose, let me tell you very frankly, we should make dua also. Ya Allah, I am doing tawbah from my sins. So please, help me to keep my tawbah update. And give himmat. We should know that we cannot stop any sin, we cannot do any hasanat without courage. Courage is very important. Dua and courage will help us to stop the sins what we're committing and have a life free from the sins. This is a command, this is a hukum, this is a wajib. To do tawbah from the sin is a wajib, it is a farz on us. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made wajib and a farz on us? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us. He brought us from Jannah. He wants to take us back to the Jannah. But in the Jannah, the person with the dirt of shirk and kufr and sins and zina, such kind of sins, maybe zahiri sin, maybe batini sin, like arrogance. So with such dirties, with such dirt of sins, the person cannot enter in the Jannah. Therefore, before the last breath, before the last breath, we should keep our account neat and clean, clear from the sins, so that we can enter Jannah right after the last breath. Our grave should become a piece of Jannah. And now question, when should we do tawbah? Should I wait for the Hajj? Should I wait for the Isha Salat? When I do the zikr of istighfar? No. We have to keep our eye open every moment. If by chance any sin, small or big, is committed, We should not wait for 1 minute even. I should do tawbah, istighfar right away. Why? Because the death has no calendar at all. So this should be purpose of our life, to keep our record neat and clean from any kind of crime. So now, what kind of sins we may commit? Some sins are related to the Khalik, and other kind of sins related to the makhluk. Example, first of all, the biggest sin related to the Khalik is a shirk. Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. We Muslim are free from this shirk. Alhamdulillah. But some kind, we are involved in minor kind of shirk. Example, to do sajda on the grave, or to have belief in any person, holy person, he will do it. No. So Alhamdulillah, as a whole, we Muslim Ummah, when you say La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, then we become free from the major sin of a shirk. But we should keep our eye open, be very watchful. Therefore, we should have closeness to the ulama-e-karam so that we get their guidance. I'm not committing any case of a shirk. Example other, to do nazar, do qurbani in the name of XYZ person. Because qurbani, a nazar, a qasam, only her relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Other, 5 times salat is a hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The person who does not make salat, he only makes Juma Salat or only Eid Salat. What about 5 Salat? This is a farz. This is a Kabira sin if we don't make Salat. I can do fasting, but I don't do fasting. This is a Kabira sin. I'm eligible to go to Hajj, but I don't do Hajj. Waiting for this, waiting for that. That's Kabira sin. Zakat is due. I have enough ornament, gold, deposit in the bank. I have land, a lot of properties, renting the properties. I am supposed to give zakat. Their collection also. We are not ulama. We should go to any mufti, any alim. We should have a relation with any scholar to whom you trust, to in each area of Islam, we get his guidance. We are supposed to give zakat. So these are the example, few example. In little time I'll give you the sins related to the Khalik. What should we do now? How we do tawbah? We have to sit down, check yourself, how many salat, since I became adult, I did not perform, I did not do salat. We have to count it. How much zakat I did not pay? Because I just came to know now. How much zakat is due for how many years? So we have to take care of that. As I told before, we have to calculate salat. We should make tour ka nafal tawbah. Aur jis se astaghfirullah rabbi min kulli zambin wa tub ilayhi. Ya Allah, I seek forgiveness. I did not make salat so many thousand or so many hundred. Then we have to actually make salat. That is through tawbah. Just by doing tawbah, salat which I did not perform will not be forgiven. We should start making salat. Ask the ulama how to make qaza salat, which I cannot cover right now. Start making it. 5,000 salat was due. I only did 1,000. Angel of death come. The rest of the salat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with his mercy, will forgive. See, tawbah. With word, we have to do istighfar, tawbah, nafal of tawbah. And what I did not do, do it. These are related to the Khaliq. And also, sometimes we commit shirk. Sometimes we say such words, such sentence, which is kufr. We don't know that. That's why ulama-e-karam, when they do nikah, they are supposed to future husband and wife, let them give shahada also. It's very important. That's recommended. When we sleep, we should do istighfar, tawbah, at least 3 times. And do say kalma shahada before sleeping. Maybe daytime, I utter such sentence, which is sentence of kufr. This is very important. Sometimes such basabas come. So therefore, in the morning, the evening, it is recommended, do the zikr of La ilaha illallah 100 times morning, 100 times evening. And when I always recommend, when we sleep, we should sleep with La ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. Sleep with zikr of kalma tajba, and sleep, 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 mashallah. If in the night time, while sleeping, we get heart attack, we die, our last sentence will be what? La ilaha illallah. Hadith Pak says, Man kana akhir kalamihi, La ilaha illallah, dakhal al jannah. Therefore, I recommend everybody, before sleeping, please, please, do tawbah of the whole day's sins, or pass what it did, and then do kalama, say kalama tayyiba, and do sleep with the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and wake up zikr Allah. Now I am come to the sins related to the makhluk. This is a fellow being, related to the father, related to the mother. Sometimes we disobey father, sometimes we disobey mother. Sometimes we speak high in front of father. That's a kabira sin. To disobey the father and mother is a kabira sin. Be watchful. Be watchful. Therefore, we should keep our parents always happy. We should keep ourselves free from this kind of sins. I recommend that the children, the youth, adult, whose daddy and mommy still alive, I recommend every Friday evening, they should go to daddy. Daddy, please, during the whole week, something happened. I displease you. Please, for Allah's sake, dad, forgive me. Go to mommy. Go to mommy. Ask mama, please forgive me if I did something wrong. Am I good son? Make sure you receive this word. Mama says, I'm very happy with your behavior. In the same way, sometimes you commit sin in the makhluk, husband and wife. So every Friday, I recommend the husband in good mood, as your wife, honey, please forgive me if during the whole week, I did something wrong. But actually, I will not wait for the week. If day time, I was very rude, I was nasty to my wife, I disgraced her, disrespect her. Before sleeping, seek forgiveness from your wife. How many men will do? Very few. Because most of we men are rude, pride. This is a sift of shaitan. This is a sift of shaitan. Remember that. And wife should also ask husband, my dear, sorry, I did disobey you sometime. For Allah's sake, please forgive me. So we should keep our record related to the wife and husband, the spouse record, free from the sins. Weekly, I recommend, as your teacher, as your boss, even if he is a non-believer, weekly as your monthly or bi-weekly make a program, my dear boss, if I did something wrong, please forgive me. Even your servant, we should ask. Even some adult children, if daddy was bad to adult child, he should ask, son, my son, I was angry. I was in a good mood. I said something bad to you. Please forgive me. This is hard not to crack, not easy to do. But if we fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we want to enter Jannah right away, please, please keep the record neat and clean. Even we did wrong in the past life, we hit with stick some dog, some cat in Bangladesh, Pakistan. Yeah, we do over there. The dog comes to our house for food. We hit with the dog, with a stick, run away. So what should we do now? I'm here. Dog is there. Do you know that? Hadith of Bukhari Sharif. One woman was very pious, lot of nafal, but she hit a cat. And cat died. Then Musa, the Nabi of the time, was given wahi that woman who hit the cat, she drank the milk. This was her mistake. She did not cover the milk. Cat loves the milk. And that woman will go to Jahannam. Now, on the other hand, a bad lady, she quenched the thirst of a thirsty dog. Dog, animal. I'm not talking about the human being. As she was giving glad tidings, khushkhabri, she will go to Jannah. Even animals have rights on us. We should not commit any sins related to the animals. Inanimate thing. Masjid has right on us. Sometimes we commit sin related to the masjid. Example, we speak high. Imam sahab, do this. Imam sahab, what happened? How we dare to talk loud in the masjid? If anybody comes to my house and talk loud, I will not invite again. We should keep the masjid neat and clean, right? This is haq of the masjid. When we come to the masjid, we make 2 rakat nafal tahiyyatul masjid. This is the haq of the masjid. We should donate to the masjid. Why not? Who will take care? Imam cannot take care. So we have to support the masjid. We have to donate the masjid. This is the haq of the masjid. Employees have a haq on us. Even our employee, we were rude to the employee, we have to seek forgiveness from the employee also. I mean to say, we be careful. If we keep our record free from the sins, from Khaliq, related to Khaliq and Makhluk. But what will the main obstacle, main problem? Our nafs, shaitan. They say, me? I ask? Now listen what Quran says. What happened? Her Adam alayhi salatu wasalam made a mistake. So what he said? Rabbana zulamna anfusana wa illam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al khasirin. Ya Allah, I did zulm on you. If you will not forgive me, I will be among the losers. Right away, he is a Nabi of Allah. Lesson for us. Lesson for us. Do we commit any sin? Right away, do tawbah. On the other hand, Shaitan, when he committed sin, he did not do sajda. So Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, did he admit? No. He did not admit what he said. Ana khairum minhu. He gave dalil. I am better than him. All of us who are listening, if we think I am better than my wife, better than my husband, better than any other individual, even he is a kafir, who think I am better, that's the sift of shaitan. That they would ana khairum, I am better than other. Please, take away from this nafs. What shaitan happened? Ana khairum minhu, I am better than him. Then, what happened to him? Jahannami. He promised, I will. So please be careful. We should become the son of Adam and not son of Shaitan. We should not follow the track of Shaitan. Anytime mistake happens, we should stop it, seek forgiveness. Yunus alayhi salam. Here's the story. Yunus alayhi salam was doing tabligh, and the people didn't listen. He said, let me leave them alone. He left the city. He went out of the city. What happened? Some wise people get together. They did mashwara. Look, where is Yunus alayhi salam? He's not here. He gone out of the city. They did mashwara. Look, we did not obey the Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. Now azab may come. But the city people did tawbah. Subhanallah, they did tawbah. The azab, the punishment of disobeying the prophet, it was raised up. On the other hand, to teach us a lesson to the ummah, to Muslimin, non-Muslimin, until day of Qiyamah, he was gone in the stomach of whale, a long story, where he is. Little istihadi, little mistake, but for the lesson to us, Nabi was there. Such jail, no air, darkness of the night, darkness of the day, and dark of the water. No attorney there. Where to go? Sometime we face such situation. We cry, Ya Allah, what happened to me? How I get out of this situation? Happened to me. At that time, what helped Yunus alayhi salam? Quran says, "Hey, my Yunus, had not did istighfar, had not done zikr, he was staying there." What zikr he did there? The zikr, accepting his mistake, or begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min az-zalimin. Sapro. ला इलाहा इल्ला अंता सुभानका इन्नी कुंतु मिनज़ ज़ालिमीन। ला इलाहा इल्ला अंता सुभानका इन्नी कुंतु मिनज़ ज़ालिमीन। ही डिड द ज़िक्र, सुभानअल्लाह, एक्सेप्टिंग द मिस्टेक, डूइंग द तौबा। अल्लाह का कमांडर द फिश द व्हेल थ्रो हिम आउट ऑफ द ओशन। यू सी, हियर द लेसन, हियर द प्रेस्क्रिप्शन, वजीफा आई एम गिविंग टू यू। वेन यू हैव सच मिस्टेक, प्लीज, सच प्रॉब्लम, फ्रंट फायर, बैक ओशन, राइट स्नेक, लेफ्ट स्कॉर्पियन, स्टक अप। वेन यू स्टक अप, क्राइंग, बिजनेस फेल, वाइफ डिसोबीडियंट, हस्बैंड डिसोबीडियंट, व्हाट यू डू, आई विल रिकमेंड यू फर्स्ट लेसन, थिंक ओवर, डू मशवरा विद अ वाइफ, विद अ फ्रेंड, व्हाट कबीरा, व्हाट सिन वी आई कमिटेड। यू अंडरस्टैंड, थिंक ओवर व्हाट सिन आई कमिटेड, टेक केयर दैट सिन, टेक केयर दैट सिन, स्टॉप इट। एंड आफ्टर इशा सलात या फजर सलात, सिट डाउन, रिलैक्स, डू दिस जिक्र, अव्वल थ्री टाइम सलवात इब्राहिमी, एंड देन यू डू जिक्र ला इलाहा इल्ला अंता सुभानका 101 टाइम, क्राइंग क्राइंग, देन सलात इब्राहिमी आफ्टर दैट थ्री टाइम। इंशाल्लाह व्हेन यू डू जिक्र एज यू आर स्टक अप, डू दिस जिक्र ला इलाहा इल्ला अंता सुभानका इन्नी कुंतु मिनज़्ज़ालिमीन। इंशाल्लाह विद इन फ्यू आवर यू विल बी आउट ऑफ द सिचुएशन, अल्लाह सॉल्व योर प्रॉब्लम। यू अंडरस्टैंड ब्रदर, बट यू हैव टू एवेल्युएट सम टाइम व्हाट हैपन, माय बिजनेस गो डाउन, लूज द जॉब, यू नो व्हाट हैपन सम टाइम, डिसओबीडियंस ऑफ द फादर, वी गेट द पनिशमेंट बिफोर डेथ। मेक श्योर, कीप ऑलवेज हैप्पी योर फादर। जब आई रिकमेंड द फादर, पेरेंट्स ऑलवेज मेक दुआ फॉर योर चिल्ड्रन, इवन हाउ बैड दे आर, नेवर मेड बैड दुआ। द सेम वे, इफ वी आर डिसओबीडियंट टू आवर फादर, माई चिल्ड्रन विल बी डिसओबीडियंट। यस सर, व्हाट वी सो सेम वी रीप, जो बोगे वो काटोगे। सो नाउ वी गॉट द लेसन दैट प्लीज वी शुड लीड द लाइफ फ्री फ्रॉम सिंस, सो दैट सून दे क्लोज द आईज द जन्ना इज वेटिंग फॉर अस। कीप योर रेकर्ड नीट एंड क्लीन ऑफ एवरी काइंड एंड सीकिंग फॉरगिवनेस। नाउ इन द एंड आई से लिटिल पोएट्री, उर्दू पीपल विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट के वी आर कमिटिंग सिन डे एंड नाइट, बट अल्लाह सुभान व तआला स्टिल फॉरगिविंग अस। इस यहाँ से कभी हमने किनारा ना किया, इस यहाँ में होता है गुना। इस यहाँ से कभी हमने किनारा ना किया, पर तूने भी दिल आज़ुर्दा हमारा ना किया। हमने तो जहन्नम की बहुत तदबीर, सिन वन गो टू जहन्नम, पर तेरी रहमत ने गवारा ना किया, पर तेरी रहमत ने गवारा ना किया। इस यहाँ से कभी हमने किनारा ना किया, पर तूने भी दिल आज़ुर्दा हमारा ना किया। हमने तो जहन्नम की बहुत तदबीर, पर तेरी रहमत ने गवारा ना किया। देयरफॉर माय रिस्पेक्टेड ब्रदर्स एंड एल्डर्स एंड नाज़रीन सामीन, प्लीज़ प्लीज़, अल्लाह रहमत इज देयर वेटिंग विद देयर वन ड्रॉप ऑफ दिस आंसू विल क्विट द जहन्नम। एंड देयर इज पर्शियन वर्डिंग लास्ट थिंग, व्हाट एवर कंडीशन वी आर, हाउ बैड वी आर, हाउ मेनी सिन वी कमिटेड, अल्लाह सुब्हान तआला वेलकम अस। बाज़या बाज़या हर आँच हस्ती बाज़या, ट्रांसलेट पर्शियन, कम बैक, अल्लाह सुब्हान तआला से कम बैक, व्हाट एवर यू आर, व्हाट कैन सिन यू कमिटिंग, कम बैक। बाज़या बाज़या हर आँच हस्ती बाज़या, कर कुफरो गिबरो बुत परस्ती बाज़या, इवन यू डिड कुफर शिर्क, व्हाट कैन सिन यू कमिटेड, आवर डोर्स ओपन। बाज़या बाज़या हर आँच हस्ती बाज़या, कर कुफरो गिबरो बुत परस्ती बाज़या, इन दरगाह मा दरगह ना उम्मीदी ने, डोंट गेट डिस्पेयर्ड, ला तक ला तू मेरा रहमतिल्ला, डोंट वरी, एवर यू कमिट 99 यू मर्डर यू डू, कम बैक टू तौबा, कम बैक। बाज़या बाज़या हर आँच हस्ती बाज़या, कर गुफरो गिबरो बुत परस्ती बाज़या, इन दरगाहे मा दरगहे ना उम्मीदी ने, सद बार घर शिकस्ती बाज़या। इफ यू डिड तौबा एंड यू ब्रोक द तौबा 100 टाइम, स्टिल कम बैक। मे अल्लाह सुब्हान तआला हेल्प मी एंड यू टू प्योर लीव द प्योर लाइफ फ्री फ्रॉम द सिन्स व आखिर दामाना अन अलहम्दुलिल्लाह रब्बिल आलमीन। जज़ाकल्लाह खैर। After Juma khutbah, I'll be here and I have your question, most welcome. Jazakallah khair.